Music Radio WLAS.
To be with you, Rush Limbaugh, the EIB Network, and...
Good morning, everybody.
Hello, friends. Welcome to the show.
What's up, beer drinkers? We got another great show for you again this week.
Here's Dan Hampton and Ed O'Brien.
Hey, it's Conrad Thompson, and you're listening to...
All right, you know why we're here. So if you have any doubts or reservations, now is the time to say so. No one will think any less of you. Because once you enter this family, there's no getting out.
This is where this gets difficult.
It is the Lingus Mafia podcast number 499.
Ooh.
And that's only this show. We have done 8 billion shows if I could add it up together. I'm Cat Manning. I'm the boss of this family. I'm alongside my consigliere. That is Fausty Walnuts.
What do you hear? What do you say?
And I am along with our underboss slash bizookie. That is Gregorio.
Buonasera.
I was going to say, where's the Kleenex? Should I get this out for the disaster that was?
I was hoping to crack open a bottle of champagne. But
a bit of the bubbly?
Instead, it'll be the usual misery and sadness.
Oh, my God. Yeah, welcome to the Super Bowl show, folks, because this is what this show is going to fucking be. I wrote down every notable commercial when it popped on with a note, maybe, you know, did that whole thing. So we'll go through the commercials later and shit like that, in which there's like two that I fucking really popped from. It's funny because I wrote best one so far, and the next one that followed it, I said, and maybe even better. It was like two were killer back to back. So when we were all texting each other on the side during the game, we like to comment and, you know, we, do commentary, for the game, and it was looking okay in the first half, but right where Mahomes wants you, you know, is this, he's the new, Brady, where we all say, if he gets the ball last, this game is fucking over. And it's always that way. I wanted to know on the radio who was, the GOAT in the bad version of it. Who they were saying was at fault for this whole thing. And we were trying to figure out, we were all taking bets on where this was going to lie and who everybody, because people will cry, of course, overreacting.
Yeah.
They're ready to fire Shanahan, I'm sure. I'm sure somebody has yelled this. I've never heard anything. I didn't listen to anything. But there's always somebody. There's something for everybody, of course, which let me know if you fire Shanahan. I'll be knocking on his door. to find out. What did you hear on the radio, Fausti? Because you are the one who is in the bay of the three of us.
Mm-hmm. I didn't hear any fire Shanahan. I heard a lot of second guessing the decision and the overtime rules and people not knowing the overtime rules.
Yeah.
I agree with, you know, that too, but one of the key points in the game was the Niners getting an interception, right?
Yeah.
Was that the third
quarter? That was right after they got the ball back to start the third. Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Yeah. The kickoff ball. Yeah.
They do three pass plays, three and out. Mm. Stop the Chiefs, get the ball back, three pass plays, three and out. They passed six times in a row. Run the fucking ball. I think, you know, after the pick, Kyle was like, fuck it. I'm going, you know, I'm getting this momentum. I want to score.
Yeah.
But it didn't work out, and it was just a momentum killer on the other side. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I was noticing. Like, it even floated out of my head into the second to where I went, oh, yeah, by the way, run the ball. I was like, I completely forgot that. Yeah, that whole fucking beginning was that.
Like, on the first drive, he looked good, and then he fumbled. And then they were containing him a little bit, you know, but you still got to fucking run the ball.
Just keep – that's what he is. And
that's what they do. And go away from it. It's – look at – look at the other fucking Super Bowls. He stopped running the ball, and that's what happens.
It's injuries don't help. And I've heard the quote unquote experts when I listen to all these, you know, just the neutral shows, and everybody, you know, talks about it, like in the Bears, or not the Bears, but Chicago radio talks about it. Best Bets talked about it. You maybe have heard that, Greg, the Ross Tucker thing. And they both agreed. They said, would it have been different if those injuries don't happen? And I'm like, it's very hard. I mean, who the fuck knows? You're right. But they both said, you
get Kelsey's stats first half versus second half.
Oh, fuck.
Big difference.
Yeah, that was a big. And one of my bets on the Billy's thing was him over the 75. And I'm like, well, this is a fucking dud with one fucking reception, you know? And then all the maniac right wingers fucking want Kelsey kicked out of the entire league because he bumped into Andy. It's a disgrace. I'm like, yeah, he was a fucking douchebag. That's 100% fucking right. But
it does look bad.
He does.
It would have looked like even worse had they lost.
Oh, it would have looked worse. I thought you would say if he fell.
Oh, that would have been
a fucking old man with a new hip and he falls. You imagine they having to cart him out and fucking game's over. Yeah, but yeah, it's always this. I like somebody even posted one of these fucking goofy things that are reporters, quote unquote. Kelsey and Swift said if Trump wins, they're leaving the country. What do you think?
Oh, Jesus.
And the fucking notification right underneath it on Twitter is neither of them have said any of this. And I'm like, well, this is some fucking reporter over here. But it's like, yeah, there was a lot of injuries, especially walking onto the field and blowing yourself.
He was already unreal. He had missed the game late in the year because of his Achilles.
Really? So like it was just sore?
He missed the game with like Achilles tendonitis.
Oh,
so
it was telling
already
you.
Banged up. Yeah.
That's scary that you go, ooh, maybe it's on its last strings, you know? Yikes. I always worry about that injury because it's a fucking nobody does anything and it fucking explodes like that. You're like, just push off the line at all if you're gonna, you know, run it all. You could just go bang and happen. And
he's got to call Rogers. Hey, can I get your doctor, please?
Yeah, I'll be back. And he'll be back by the half. I can play. I know Greg was probably drowning his misery in the gayest nachos you've ever seen. But
thank you. My little nacho boots.
he had them at Kazoo, Faust. They were floating down on the little nachos. What were your thoughts on the whole thing, Greggy?
Yeah, you're right. When they came out in the second half and they just kept throwing, I'm like, what the fuck are they doing? You got to pound the rock.
Yeah.
You got to pound the rock. And I just kept yelling at I just kept commenting at the screen, like, run the ball, run the ball. My daughter kept getting mad.
They have the offensive player of the league on the team.
It's amazing. It's amazing how he just abandons a run so quickly sometimes.
It is fucking real weird because it's like they fucking obviously know a billion times more than what the fuck we do. But for everybody to realize you're not doing what was like working, that is just, it's almost overthink or something. And like they'll be keyed in for the run. So now I'm going to throw it, really fuck them up. And it's like, I do it until I'm hitting a fucking wall at that point where I'm not trying to make it fun for the fans. I don't care if you're bored. I'm never passing now. It's if you do five every time, I'm never fucking throwing the ball. I don't care. And run the whole time, and then I'm kneeling for the rest of the fucking game. I don't care.
Yeah, if you're worried about usage, throw Mitchell in there. He could run too.
Yeah, and he did. Yeah. He got a couple
runs.
What's funny is Billy bet on the under of 1.5 attempts. And I
really?
I go,
you got two, right?
Yeah. I was like, fucking crazy. And I was like, just as a breather, he's got to get in the fucking game. Because he's like, I don't think they'll ever put him in because he'll be close, you know, at all time to like, we're not blowing anyone out. We keep going.
It's crazy that the Niners were in the game and had a chance to win, considering Ayuk, Debo, and Kittle combined for like 80 yards.
I wasn't Kittle fucked up too, and
yeah,
he got rolled up on
practicing
one
for the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, I heard. The latest was where the fuck? I think it was on that Best Bets, Greg. Ayuk was talking about getting the fuck out. He wants to leave. Did you hear that?
On Instagram, his brother was chirping. Like this 1,300-yard season, and don't throw them in the Super Bowl. That's why we out. And then it was like AB to Vegas or something. I'm like, so you want to go to Vegas and get the ball?
I think he's saying AB, like the same thing, I guess. AB to Vegas.
BA to LV.
Oh, okay, there you go. Yeah, that what the fuck? Let me go to a place that has no quarterback at all either. Fucking, and he'll get the ball because the other guy there gets the ball a lot too, right? Devonta.
That's right. The what do you call it? The wide receivers are deep this draft, so they get a wide receiver first round.
There you go. Well, I know in Chicago they were like, "Ooh, Ayuk want to fucking leave?" Like, pardon me, I hear you over there. So they would fucking swoop, I'm sure, if that's the fucking case, and grab another fucking wide receiver to throw the fucking ball to.
Just make Lynch's job easier. That's all he's doing.
You know, at the same time, it's like when these people fucking hoot and holler, unless you are a crazy superstar, and you got to be a crazy high superstar to not just go goodbye. Who needs somebody yelling at me? You know, who the fuck are you? You know, especially. And I'm like, yeah, and he's not the number one over there either with Debo running fucking wild.
No, he's the number one.
He is the number one? Really? It's not Debo?
No, you said back-to-back 1,000 yards.
Oh, I take
seasons.
That's funny because I would take
Debo. He's a better receiver.
That's so funny because you don't. I don't feel on the outside of not being in Niner world. Like, you don't hear of him. Like, you just you hear it, but you don't.
Quiet. He's more quiet because he's behind Debo because Debo gets, you know, the runs and the bigger plays. But IU, more receptions, more yards last 2 years. Hmm.
So has anybody chirping about Brock? Anything on him?
No.
Not his fault?
Just, you know, he played okay. He played, didn't play bad. He didn't turn the ball over. Didn't play great.
It's always the, throws. It's always the, you could do better. One of those that, like, we can get somebody who's better because I heard
in his second season, he's in the Super Bowl. So, I mean, it's not like, I don't know.
It's like you can get a fucking monster. Well, sure. Yeah. Why not?
Yeah.
But then I hear people actually said, they said, would you take Cousins over him? And I'm like, I guess in reality, you got to think, cause they go, just the name alone. You go, no. You just hear it and you go, no, I know. I've seen this. However, it's not like he's some fucking shit quarterback. We've seen he's fucking good. So you're like, him with all that around? That's not too fucking with that team has so fucking much around it where
his Cousins willing to make $1 million next year.
Big cut.
It works.
Take a little bit less. Jesus Christ. Oh, and now
I've been going back and forth with Greg, the NBA expert.
Uh-huh.
Because he sends me a where is this?
My favorite is Big Ed in bed with all his text, copy and paste.
Oh fuck.
It's my favorite. We'll talk about that in a minute. Wait till you guys hear this.
It's a screenshot of the last play in overtime, right? The winning play.
Oh, with the guy who's that play. I'm thinking the Niner one with the wide open.
On the winning touchdown. There's the Chiefs had an illegal man downfield.
The Chiefs,
it evens out.
I was gonna say, didn't they
Niners
say
touchdown,
yes.
They did too.
I was gonna say, didn't what's his name? It was Phil Simms was the one who said it? He was like, at halftime, he's like, that one shouldn't even have counted anyway.
No, it was Boomer.
Was it Boomer who said it?
Yeah, I remember when Boomer said
it. I can never tell him apart.
I'm like, I know you're a hater.
wasn't there a commercial they did that too?
What, we can't tell them apart? Oh, yeah, he called him by the wrong fucking name. Yeah, the Geico guy. Jesus.
So there, at that point on the screenshot, there's 4 seconds left on the clock when the Kansas City scores. So the argument is that's a penalty. If properly called by officials, that's 10-second runoff. Game over, the Niners win.
But you imagine this game rules, ends.
Because if you read the rules, unlike some of the Niner players were fucking informed.
Yes.
Because I had to read it. I go, I don't even know how these fucking rules work either. I didn't realize they were different. Because I'm like, why is there a first OT?
Yeah. And a goes OT? Forever. Okay.
So even if they did call the penalty, the Chiefs would still have the ball. If the clock runs out, it would just go into a second OT because it's their first possession.
It's true.
Had they been on their second possession, that's different. Then you're fighting against the clock.
Yeah.
To score.
I am shocked that a lot of the players on the Niners like admitted flat out they didn't know the rules for overtime.
Yeah.
Who was it? Who was it who said it was a defensive lineman, wasn't it? He said he wasn't aware.
Armstead.
There you go. That's exactly.
It was Armstead and Juszczyk.
That's fucking crazy. And then I'm watching the post thing on NFL Network. I'm sure you guys just threw the TV out the window at this fucking point.
It's funny. I flipped it to the local cable Niner post game show, and I hit record, but I couldn't watch it. I'm like, I'll watch it later. It's still sitting there. I don't know if I will.
Let me torture myself a little bit. Fuck. I tuned to a channel that showed all Bears draft pick bus, and I got that on tape to watch later on.
Oh yeah, Bears are on the clock.
That's it. Bears are on the clock, baby. Here we go. And Mahomes goes up to the thing about because Hardman didn't know that he won, which is, I don't know how that's possible. That's too. A weird one.
It doesn't matter what the rules are. Like, what the fuck?
And he had no idea. So then he said that they were told these new rules in preseason. They were filled in about this, but he said during these 2 week things, he said they did this to us every day. They told us the rules every day, and he goes, I was so fucking sick of hearing about it. And then and then it happened. He's like, oh. And I'm like, that's a fucking coach, man. I'm like, every possible situation you are prepared. Because I didn't know until Nance was like, the clock was ticking with 5 seconds. And I'm like, what the fuck are they out of their mind? They're not kicking the field goal. Mm-hmm. And then he was like, it's just another quarter. I was like, oh.
Yeah.
And I was thinking maybe that's what caught the Niners flat-footed. Like, they were like, they're going to fake hike this and time out. They're not going to go for it. And then they went for it. It was like, what are you guys, nuts? You're going for it? The game's, if you fuck up, it's over. You know, but then nobody knows. But, fuck.
Yeah. I've heard both sides of the argument, too, about
taking it
first.
With
the new rules, if you want the ball first or second. Because normally you'd. When you always want the ball first, because if you score a touchdown, game's over. But with the new rules, it's different. Score a touchdown, the other team still gets a shot to score a touchdown.
Yeah. Except for, only with now NFL playoff football where it's.
Yeah, that's what I mean, the playoffs.
Yeah, different. Otherwise it's always first. And
apparently the Chiefs said they would have deferred.
Yeah.
And if the Niners scored a touchdown.
Went for
and
two.
They scored a touchdown. They would say, we're not fucking around. We'll go for two.
That's, oh my God. Talk about throwing up. Oh, fuck. Because then you're fucked, though, because you're just going to get a field goal and the end of it and be lost if they do get it the third time, which is, I mean, it's a hard fucking choice, but I get where don't take the ball first because now you have four downs every time knowing what the other team did and you have a better, you know. That's
a little rough. True. When you're playing from behind, then you know you have four downs to play with.
That's why in college you always say, "I'll take it second because I got to see what you do first and then figure it out." So I don't know. Now Kyle is he getting that rep of being known of the double digits. You know, like fuck. Ugh, it was.
Stop getting those leads.
Yeah, he didn't all fucking playoffs. What the fuck is he doing now? Meanwhile, we said this is the game he can't not have the lead in.
Oh, yeah.
Well, unless you have Mahomes back there. I saw the over-under for next year was 10.5 for Kansas City. And people were like, oh, jump on that. Now, they got 11 now. And the worst season they've ever had, probably, so, you know, with Mahomes and shit. It was like, it's a shit season, and they had 11 wins. That's fucking sad. But they also were talking about, you know, after two times of going deep into the playoffs, injuries now, and there could be a big issue. And we'll see. And because it's going to be, as we well know, right, it's going to be Seahawks and Kansas City now next year because of the logo. That shows yeah. This is the one.
The Ravens fucked it up this year.
They did. They fucked it up. Whole thing. Yeah. Oh, man.
I say we just wait for who is it? Schrager who makes the preseason yes. pick. Then we'll
jump on him.
Week one.
That's when we mush him. That is crazy. For like 4 years he's done that.
Yeah, right now the Niners are favored right now to mm-hmm. win the Super Bowl next year, +500. Chiefs are +650. Ravens +900. Lions +1200.
Where's the Packers? I might have to go back to this.
Pack is +2500, so 25-1.
I think I will have to do this. Back to tradition, Faust. I had 1 year I didn't get to do this, and it was this year, and I was fucking nervous.
Yeah.
Because I think if they do beat the Niners, they're in the Super Bowl.
You know, I was contemplating texting Greg, I think, on Thursday.
Which Greg?
Minor.
Okay. Sorry, the guy on the screen with us? Because I'm thinking yeah, NBA expert. I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah, the bookie. Okay. And saying, put $100 on the Chiefs. I think I might need that emotional
hedge.
There
you go. It's the good. It's the way to do it. You
and then
put
I'm like,
money on that.
Let's see how I feel later in the week. Saturday, I'm like, nah, Niners are winning this. I started to feel like confident.
Yeah.
Like I just had that feeling,
they got
like, that vibe that they were going to pull it out somehow. I don't know. Maybe it's because I was KMBR was playing all the old Super Bowls on a marathon on Saturday. Oh,
on the radio of it, huh?
On the radio, wow. Playing the entire broadcast. I heard part of it on Sunday morning.
Old it's fucking so funny. Lon Simmons over there?
I hear. Yeah, no, it was Lon.
What's his name? The Dodger guy, right?
Yeah, the other guy that sounds like Lon.
Yes, that's why I'm thinking.
I think of his name right now. But he goes, well, good start for the Niners. Steve Young is 4-for-4 with 2 touchdowns.
Was it first or second play of the game? I always get it wrong. Second play?
I think it was the second play.
To Rice over the middle. Fucking yeah. Seamed them. Yeah. I have that on videotape still. Now you could just fucking get everything. I'm like, I still have the video of it.
Yeah. Last week on NFL Network, I watched all the America's Game, mm-hmm. the Niners, watched the Football Life, the
That's what's
Super
always
Bowl
good.
Highlights.
It's so good when your team is in and you have, it's like, the week is dedicated to those teams. And you're like, it's everything. That's all I fucking would watch is the fucking NFL networks and shit like that. All the, and everything, you know, it was in 2006. Fuck. It's been a while.
You know what? Going to the Super Bowl is overrated, especially if your team loses. So I just recommend.
If they lose, it is very overrated.
I recommend, you know, Rob, it's been a while too. It's no fun.
You're better off just being a loser.
You're thinking of Joe Starkey?
There you go, Joe Starkey.
Oh. Yeah.
With see, Wayne Walker on color.
Yeah.
Who am I thinking of? What's his guy's name from
Lon
the Dodgers?
Lon Simmons was there, too. But Lon Simmons used to do the Niners.
The main thing. Guy from the Dodgers now. That he's gone. Who
oh,
did the
you're
radio?
Thinking of Vin Scully.
There you go, Vin Scully. It wasn't Vin Scully didn't do it?
No. He didn't
at all.
Like on the radio the anyway.
He did. He did the catch. That's what he did.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm like, I fucking know this motherfucker did something over here. Boy, yeah, I was tooling around with DraftKings, seeing about giving points with the Niners and seeing how much I could make. Mm-hmm. And I put the fucker to like, oh, I'll give the Chiefs 6 points. The Niners are going to fucking win this oh, wow. by 7. Yeah, I want to see because I go, if it was a crazy thing, mm-hmm. fuck yes, I'm put. Why not? You know, and it was barely anything. And I'm like, what the fuck? It might be. Whatever you put down is what you got back. So I'm like, it ain't worth a fucking do. If I was triple my fucking money, you'd give it a shot. But it wasn't worth it to do. So that's why I wanted to hedge my bet and put money on the Chiefs to where now it's like I didn't even bet on the Niners that $50 because I got it right back. Stevens. Yeah, exactly. Greg sent us our – did he send to you? I would assume he did as well. Your file.
Spreadsheet.
Yeah. Yes, your spreadsheet. And we were so close to ever getting that damn $1,000 right underneath the motherfucker.
Well, about a week ago, we were close. And then this last week.
Yeah, it's like you go into these streaks. You're like, fuck, Cody gets that fucking sweep for us. And it really fucking boosts us up.
We did well in the Super Bowl, though.
We did.
We did above even.
How about the one bet that actually hit the three consecutive scores? That hit.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Yeah, that hit, and I didn't know it too until hearing that best bet show, and they were like, "Yeah, that was," and it was the Chiefs. They did the three scores in a row. So I'm like, "Hey, that,
in a row,
that bet actually worked." So, but there was, I know I was on the ones I gave out on the Billy show. I believe I was 6-2. I only fucked up two of those. And one was a damn punt by fucking the 49ers. Killed me with the longest punt.
Be over
56. Yeah. He needed to get 57, yeah, right? And he get 55. I'm like, fuck. God damn it. So, yeah, that didn't work. And then there was one other bet that we did.
The Boomin' Onion. That's his nickname.
You needed a Boomin' regular kicker. That motherfucker, I don't trust for shit. He could kick him far. Oh, Moody. That's for sure.
Yeah.
He held a record for a couple minutes, but
blame the O-line on that.
The other one, the block?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's also him going low, no? It's an extra point. You pop it up. Mm. I don't know, him and his mustache with those squinty eyes. I don't know. He looks shady to me.
I know that first attempt. I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go.
It was like, I couldn't believe that I did it. I cursed him when I said, no more scoring. I have the squares. I would win $400. The rest of this doesn't score. And I'm assuming, well, that is including the extra point.
I don't think he had missed one all season.
And then he
missed them in preseason. That's why we got nervous. I'm like, this motherfucker's missing PATs. And then the regular season, I think he made all his.
And then he fucking misses, and I go, no, I didn't mean yet. Fuck, you heard me. No. You
would have just waited.
Just wait.
Another minute.
That's all I needed was a minute. Which then almost pretty much then cost the fucking game, too, because they would have had to go for the touchdown instead of the tie. Yep. Oh, my God. Yeah. Oh, God bless football. I know Faust turned into Seth Rollins during it, but I hate football.
To paraphrase Joe Exotic, I don't know if I will emotionally recover from this.
Yeah, I was like messaging Wonder Boy, you know, and I'm like, oh, fuck, you know, beforehand. I'm like, fuck him, go get him, let's go, you know, and all that. And he's yelling more about, not about the overtime rules or anything. He's just like, he goes, just fucking get a touchdown in overtime, though. Fuck, that's all.
Yeah.
The thing that hurts the most too is the Niners defense came to play. Like, I was worried about their D line. Like Chase Young, I'm like, fuck, this guy.
He's been dog piss. Yeah.
He's been trash. There was a video going around from the playoffs where he's just not hustling.
He olays. Yes. It was Detroit, right? It was like,
yeah.
All right.
But he played a great game, and then, I mean, the Chiefs didn't score. The only scoring touchdown drive they had was the one play after the fucked up punt.
Right away. Yeah, right away. Boom.
Other than overtime, but regular. Yeah.
It's always the little, if you just didn't do that, if you just had this.
I've often heard it's a game of inches. I don't know if you've ever heard that.
You claw for every inch. Man. Let's go over to the other side. We're going to talk some of these commercials that went on and a little bit.
Tell me about them, because they're all blur to me.
Yeah, I was going to say, you guys didn't even know there was a fucking commercial that would play it. I fucking you groove a nice thing in your carpet when you walk back and forth, pacing like a fucking waiting for your wife pacing to deliver. Fuck.
Well, it was from here to the kitchen to the refrigerator, grab another beer.
You didn't just have a cooler next to you. That's what you should be doing.
Probably should have.
Is the wife recovering from the black eyes that you gave her during? you son of beating child, all that good stuff. So, all right, kids, we're going to jump over to the other side and talk a little more footsie ball over there. So make me you sign up. That's on patreon.com/LingusMafia. If you want these full complete shows all the time. And for wrestling, no commercials, all that good stuff. Otherwise, we'll be on the Creative Control Network is where you're going to find us for wrestling. Because, Faust, what number show are we on this network?
Number 3.
But number 1 in your hearts, motherfucker. And, Faust, we're not here to make friends.
We're here to get downloads.
That's how it works, Greg. You see how we do it? We're smooth. That's awesome. Now we're smooth. All right, kids, we'll be over there.
What do you think about that?
What? You haven't signed up to patreon.com/LingusMafia yet? Not only will you get the second half of this show on time on Tuesdays, you could also go back in our history for over 500 plus shows. Who could forget show number 29, My Hatred for Aaron Rodgers?
Watching this fucking team of mine, this fucking Aaron Rodgers, if the fucking plane went down, I would fucking dance. I don't care. I'm a piece of shit. I don't fucking care. Ah, it's just a game. I hate their fucking guts. It's constantly fucking losing to them.
Spit Roasting, a show with Rob, Jeremy, and Fausty Walnuts, where they go over many topics, including farting in front of your wife.
I remember I was on one of the aisles, right? And I farted. I smelt it, and I moved on to the next aisle. And then she walked down that same aisle. And I remember she kind of gave me a look like, oh, what the fuck? Like, out loud, she goes, oh, my God, it fucking stinks.
I'm laying in bed on my side, and I farted with a lot of reverb, yeah. You know? The vibration of the air coming out of my ass started trickling down my leg to my foot. My,
what? Like, all the way to your foot?
My foot was vibrating. Like, I could feel the vibrations in my the last three seconds of that part, like, I can feel my foot vibrating.
So get on over to patreon.com/LingusMafia and see what you've been missing.
And Greg's comeback was, yeah, I feel sorry for your kids, too. With a fucking little wink and a smile on the side.
I would have replied, are they Warrior fans?
There you go. You got to watch that. It was Ribbon on the Square, Faust, is what Greg was doing there. And so then Rob.
You're sorry for your mother.
Oh, shit.
And then Rob replied with a picture, which I had to zoom in because I didn't know what the hell I was looking at. And it was Cartman drinking the tears of another child. Oh, okay. Fucking died.
Scott, what was his name? Scott Fitterman or
Scott Tetterman.
Fitterman.
I was like, fuck, because you know Rob is just rubbing his hands when the Niners lost. He's like, yes, good. Enjoying every minute he can.
That's when Cartman made that kid eat his parents.
Oh, geez.
That's right. Parents were murdered, and he put their bodies in chili because they were having a chili cook.
Oh, my God, Faust. It's like Pepper, the fucking Chihuahua with the boss, man, for God's sake. I'm like, I got an idea for a show. How about we make them eat their parents? Jesus Christ. Kid's going to turn into Batman. Watch out. All right.
No, he's the coon.
We're going to go over there, and we're going to talk some more. So remember, I can do anything I want. Unless it's against my homes, I can't do nothing at that point.
Nobody can.
And we'll see you next Tuesday.
Lingus or against us.
And together, we're assholes.
Best podcast in the world.
I am the best on this microphone. Nobody can touch me.
Yours truly.
I'm done. Show's over. Good day.
Fade to black.